The place, a big bad city. The time, nighttime.
Stop! Let me go! You're hurting me!
You should have thought about that a long time ago. You should have thought about a lot of things.
Help! Who are you? Why are you doing this?
Oh, stop your stalking.
Help!
Ideally a dirty, sweaty one.
Oh, I got one! Here!
I think that was meant more rhetorically, but hey, works for me. Come on, girls, let's get him down into the basement. I never knew this was going to be so much fun. Okay, maybe you can start from the beginning and this time I could be in the front. It was just an idea.
Because, you know, it can be shortened to Tabby. As in Tabby Cat. My parents had a sense of humor. I, however, do not. I do have a healthy sense of curiosity, though, so I am like a cat in that regard. And now I get paid for it. I'm Tabitha Cat, private detective. People call me when the police can't help them. Or when they've been through the list of all the male detectives and found they've been booked up or conflicted out. Which is how I wound up with the curious case of Jockstrap Malone. If you're from about these parts, you know who Jockstrap Malone is. Famous local sportscaster. Broadcast a lot of high school games. Sort of a local celebrity. He'd be the MC at a lot of local events. Ribbon cuttings, charity auctions. Parades, that sort of thing. And then one day, he went missing. Now, truth be told, the station didn't notice at first. It seems Malone had a thing for the bottle. And if he disappeared on a bender for a few days, well, away on special assignment. And no one was the wiser. Malone went on a lot of special. But when this one particular special assignment stretched on a whole week, and then another week, well, the station got worried. Sweeps week was coming. They needed him for the ratings. They checked out his place. His car was still there. But he wasn't. The station assumed the worst. They figured another one of Malone's vices finally caught up with them. Gambling debts. Which is probably how they wound up calling me. Because, you know, all the male detectives, well, they either owed him money or he owed them money. And that is one area where I have a marked advantage. I won't say I'm incorruptible, because I'm not. I just have different vices. Nobody thinks to offer to buy me off with a box set of Agatha Christie novels. So anyways, I had a case. First, it seems simple. Check out the bars. Talk to some bookies. If it really was gambling debts, you'd figure somebody somewhere would know something, and sooner or later, they'd let something slip. I'd even lay odds on it. Which is how I ended up at this bar, the Three Sisters Lounge.
What can I get for you?
A diet soda. carbonation.
A diet soda? Really?
Who comes into a place like this and orders a diet soda?
Trixie should try to upsell her a gin and coke instead. She can still make a diet.
You know, lady, you gotta sell more than just a diet soda to make a go of this place. You don't know what the rents are around here.
I gotta watch my girlish figure. Although you can't really notice underneath this trench coat. Oh well, hope springs eternal. Hope is pretty naive if you ask me. I, however, am not. Just get me a beer.
Beer I got? What kind of information are you looking for?
Looking for someone.
Kind of slow at the moment, but you're welcome to have seats.
Oh, right over here. Ideally in my section, please.
Hey, we're taking turns, remember? And I go first, because I'm older than you are.
You're always older than I am.
I'm looking for, this fellow right here. No, name's Malone. Goes by Jockstrap Malone. I don't want to know why.
No, can't say I have.
How about you girls? You ever seen this fellow?
I think it's more like this. No, haven't seen him at all. Total stranger, total non-entity. Wouldn't even know him even if he came through those doors and took a street right over here, or any seat really.
Okay. Just thought I'd ask. Hangs out in a lot of bars.
We're not a bar. We're a lounge.
Yeah, we're a classy joint.
Likes to gamble.
We're definitely not that sort of establishment.
And what do you mean to like sports, let alone any sportscasters?
Yeah, so you do know them then.
No. What did I say? Absolutely not.
What I think my sister means is that she doesn't follow sports. She doesn't like people who talk about them, and she would certainly remember somebody came in here and wanted to gamble on them. Isn't that right?
Right. Yeah, Trixie here doesn't even like sports channels on the TVs.
See? Soap operas. That's us, just three sisters who like to watch soap operas all day.
I see.
But if we do see this fellow, we will be sure to let you know.
I'd appreciate it. Here's my card.
Tabitha Cat, private investigator.
I get it, like Tabby Cat. Keep the change.
Rude. All right, maybe I shouldn't have done that. But some things really get on my nerves. Anyhow, it came clear I wasn't getting anything useful out of that bar. I needed to think. Think, Tabitha, think. How do you think this could have happened? Okay, this is kind of a low-budget production, so I need you to imagine some special effects to indicate a flashback.
You're sure about this?
I'm positive.
It's been, what, 15 years?
I never forget a face.
And I never forgive an insult.
I've been watching that old, useless dud on television for the last 15 years, except only on the days when he was on special assignment.
Yes, special assignment. And looks like he's out on another special assignment right now.
Mm-hmm. And I don't even like sports. I just wanted to see his face if, you know, if I ever saw it in person.
And now we have.
And now we have.
I wonder if Trixie notices.
Trixie notices everything.
That's true.
I know there was that one time between the Giants and the Cardinals. I don't remember if it was the bottom of the ninth or the fourth quarter. I don't remember if it was a football teams or baseball teams. I bet if I had another drink, I'd remember.
Coming right up.
She notices.
You know what I can't stand? There's three things I can't stand. The designated hitter rule in baseball, the tuck rule in football, and pretty much all of soccer. It's like watching hockey on grass without any of the fun of the fighting.
Here you go.
Oh, well, yeah, don't get me started on girl sports.
I definitely won't do that. Come here. I'm pretty sure that
we know.
Pixie's had her eye on him ever since he came in.
I've had my eye on him ever since that day.
Yeah. Oh, I know. Believe me.
So, what are we gonna do? We talked about doing this. We're gonna do it, right? We're totally gonna do it.
I don't know. I mean, we talked about it so much, and it didn't think we'd ever really get the chance to.
So what's he doing here, anyways?
I don't know. He's probably run up every bar tab in town.
But we're not a bar. We're a lounge.
We've got alcohol, don't we?
Well, yeah, but we're
then we're a bar.
And that's a famous jockstrap, Malone. Are we gonna do it or not?
It's been such a long time. We were just kids when he said those things. Maybe we should just let bygones be bygones. Let sleeping dogs lie. Forgive and forget. Do you really mean that?
No. We're totally into this.
Okay.
Okay, so how are we gonna do it?
Yeah, we're gonna just talk concepts, not really details.
Well, the most important detail is sitting right over there, though.
Hey, can I get another beer?
Yeah, coming right up. Okay, you two, figure out what we've got to work with. I'll go keep them up. Bye.
Right. Gotcha.
And can you change the channel? There's a team up there named after vegetation. I mean, who names a team after vegetation? Teams should be named after scary things like lions and tigers and bears. Who names a team after a leaf? I don't care if they are the troublemaker leaf. Nobody is afraid of a leaf.
I must have hit every beer joint in town. And every gin joint, too. And tequila joint. They call them tequila bars, but I like to be consistent. Nothing. Nobody had seen him since that last day on air. Oh, they all knew Malone. Some knew him better than the others, and apparently he owed money at every bar, except for that one. That lounge. That was the only place that claimed never to have seen him come in. And I found that curious. Very curious. That could mean one of three things. One, maybe Malone had never found the place. Or two, maybe he had found the place and decided it was too high class for his taste and not ever gone in. Or three, those women running the place were lying through their perfectly orthodontured teeth. I decided to pay those ladies another visit. But first I wanted to look around a little. You never know what you can find in an alley. So this is still a low budget production. And here comes another one of those flashback scenes. So I need you to imagine lights and music and stuff. Patrons should be advised that strobe lights will be used in their imagination.
And another thing that gets my goat is team names that don't make any sense, like the LA Lakers. There are no lakes in Los Angeles. It's all desert out there. They should have left that name when they moved from Minneapolis. Oh, and don't get me started on the Utah Jazz.
Uh-huh.
In fact, there are a lot of team names that don't make sense. Why do we have the Rangers in New York and in Texas? Are they the same kind of Rangers? I don't think so. Why is that? No imagination, that's why. Hey, you know what I think would make a great team name? Hmm?
What's that?
Armadillos. What do you think? I think it's a great team name. I mean, they're tough, they're hard, they're scaly.
They jump up and down to make traffic, it could turn into roadkill.
Yeah, but think of the vertical leap. Now that's an athlete right there.
If you'll excuse me.
In fact, I got a whole list of team names here somewhere.
So, what did you find? Well, down the stock room, there was 3 boxes of napkins, 1/2 a box of salt shakers, but for some reason, no pepper shakers. And a box of plastic sporks. How can we hope to be a classy joint if we have sporks? But at the hardware store, we found some chains, some rope, dog collars in 3 sizes. We even got one for St. Bernard. Good thinking. So when are we planning on doing this?
The giraffes! Why isn't there a basketball team now named Giraffes? But no! We've got the Lakers and the Jazz. No giraffes!
I'm thinking right now. What do you say?
Sounds good. I'm in.
Okay, you know what to do.
Actually, we don't. But we'll figure it out.
Did you know there's a distinct lack of exotic animals in team names? I know, yeah, we got lions and tigers, but where are the rhinoceroses? Or the rhinoceri? You know, the ones with the big horns, not the big fat lazy ones that lay around in the water all day, the hippopotami.
Excuse me, you're Jockstrap Malone, aren't you?
Yes, I am. A one and only. Hey, you want to get my autograph? It'll cost you, though. See, I'm on a special assignment.
You sometimes MC parades, don't you?
Oh, sure. MC parades, weddings, bar mitzvahs. Hey, once I MC'd a talent show at one of the local high schools. They forgot to tell me one thing, though. You know what that was?
Oh, what's that?
I was the only talent there that night.
You emceed the local 4th of July parade.
Hello, woman. I can hardly remember last week. I remember Kirk Gibson's home run, the 88 World Series. I remember Jerry Kramer's block in the 67 Ice Bowl. I even remember the Titans. But some parade? Hell, I only do those because I have to. Besides, it pays my drinking money. And heaven knows, I need drinking money.
Well, that's too bad because we remember how you emceed that parade just like it was yesterday. Don't we, girls?
Clear as a bell.
Ooh.
Student, your memory's like a branding iron.
Well, I'll tell you what, why don't you refresh my memory after you refresh my drink?
Or better yet, we'll give you plenty of time to think about it on your own. Ooh. Do it, girls.
What? Hey, what's going on?
Hey. A little tighter.
What are you doing?
I don't want to cut him in circulation!
Ow, that hurts!
Okay, maybe I do.
There, that should do it.
What is this about? Is this about the money?
No, it's
for... I'm good for the money. I'm good for Square. I'm good for all of it.
Dude, you have no idea what this is about, do you?
So it's not about the money?
No, it's not about the money.
What is it about, then?
Well, let me think.
15 years ago, the 4th of July parade would be a good place to start.
Parade? I don't know what you're talking about.
This is about gender equality.
But I love women. That's getting at my ex-wives. All five of them.
This is about revenge.
Revenge? What did I ever do to you? I don't even know you.
Or as we prefer to call it, leadership. Come on.
Ah! Oh.
You can find some interesting things in alleys sometimes.
Dead cats.
Homeless people. Restaurant workers on a smoke break. You know what Shakespeare had to say about alleys? Not me neither. Probably something like, though she be but little, she is fierce. That's not really about alleys, but I like it anyway. You know what I like to find in alleys? Secrets, clues, and today, a dumpster filled with empty boxes of Girl Scout cookies. Now, why would that bar, lounge, why would they be going through so many Girl Scout cookies? And why would I also find a price tag for a dog collar and a length of the chain? Seems to me there are two possibilities. One, this place is a front for a bondage dungeon in the basement. Or two, they got a watchdog with a serious sweet tooth.
Help.
Samoa is my favorite, although they call him something else now.
Help.
Doesn't sound like a watchdog.
Oh!
Oh, definitely 50 shades of something going on around here. None of my business. Oh, but I wouldn't be much of a private investigator if I didn't investigate. Right. Certain sacrifices must be made. Besides, I'm not getting any younger. And then I found him.
Help! Oh, thank God, deliverance!
Hey,
you gotta get me out of here. It's horrible. Awful.
What?
So we agreed. Once the cookies run out, we'll order some more.
Right, so we'd let them go.
Well, stretch them out a bit, give them fewer, make them last longer.
Yeah, but you know what those thin mints are like. You can't have just one, you have the whole box.
Uh-oh. What?
Hey, what are you doing here?
Tracy!
I could ask you the same question. In fact, perhaps I should.
They're the ones that did this, but they're saying it's all of them. Oh, especially that little one.
What is all this racket? Anyone care to explain this?
Well, you can explain this after you let me go.
Because it seems to me that the three of you kidnapped this man and locked him in the basement for 3 weeks and fed him only
Girl Scout cookies?
Thin mints? Peanut butter patties? Everything except the caramel delights. Those were really, really good. Those we keep for ourselves, actually. I mean, I don't even know anything about them anyways, but the caramel delights, oh, those are so good.
So what is this? Some kind of
thrill kill cult? Some dark, depraved fantasy that doesn't have a name? Because I'm guessing this has nothing to do with all this gambling
debt. Hey, we could go over all this after you let me go!
Maybe it's some kind of lover's quarrel that's gotten out of hand.
With him? Get serious.
It's a witch's coven, that's what it is! They're minions of the devil, all of them. I'm not talking about the New Jersey devils either. I'm talking about the real devil with horns and everything. Oh yeah, that one even stabbed me with a pitchfork.
It was an old Halloween costume, you old fool. I mean, I don't even know anything about Halloween anyways.
No, but we do know a lot about the 4th of July.
What?
It'll be fine.
It'll be a felony.
Do you want to know why we have the city's most famous sportscaster chained up in our basement?
That was the general line of questioning, yes.
Well, I wouldn't be chained up if they'd let me go!
Be quiet. We'll get to you. I want to hear what they have to say.
15 years ago, Mr. Malone here emceed the local 4th of July parade.
Oh, so it's Mr. Malone now, is it? Oh, I haven't had that kind of respect since I first came in here.
When the local Boy Scout troop passed by the reviewing stand, Mr. Malone here called them the leaders of tomorrow.
Sounds reasonable.
But when the Girl Scouts went by, he just talked about how we sold cookies.
I do sense an imbalance.
They do sell cookies!
We were those Girl Scouts! I see. And you carried a grudge for all these years?
I wouldn't call it a grudge.
Sounds like a grudge to me.
It was a plan.
Never mind, it was a plan. We went home that night and thought about all the ways we could get even.
We talked about writing a letter to the station.
We talked about burning down the station.
We talked about getting up a petition.
We talked about getting some gasoline and some gasoline? Matches and gasoline.
We talked about writing a letter to the editor.
We even talked about making creating a Molotov cocktail, but he'll probably just say we throw like a girl anyways.
So, in the end, we compromised.
This is a hell of a compromise!
So, you waited for 15 years for your chance to lock him up and get even, and all you did is want to force-feed him Girl Scout cookies?
Hey, we're not force-feeding him. We're just not giving him anything else.
But that's a good idea.
That is quite a long time to nurse a plan.
Well, you know what the Boy Scouts say? Be prepared.
You know what the Girl Scouts say? Don't get mad.
Get even. Ah, that's a plan, not original. I like it anyway.
Well, I don't like it.
Be quiet.
I'm the injured party here.
Oh, are you? Are you really?
Oh, what does this look like?
A dog collar. Or possibly justice.
Justice? Oh, that's justice!
Now, justice would have been locking you out without the Girl Scout cookies.
So, you're not taking us to jail?
I'm a private detective. I can't arrest anybody.
But you could turn us in and keep the reward.
I could. But I'm not.
What are you gonna do then?
Me? I'm gonna walk right out of here and forget I ever saw or heard any of this.
Well, what about me?
Oh, you. Well, you can stay here.
But why?
I think it has something to do with the chain. Just a hunch.
This won't stand. I'll testify against you. I'll testify against all of you.
Oh, really? And say what? That the great Jockstrap Malone was tied up by a bunch of Girl Scouts? Or that the drunken boozer Jockstrap Malone was so inebriated he hallucinated the whole thing and tried to blame his latest bender on 3 innocent young ladies?
Hey, it's not like that. Well, maybe it's like the first part, but that doesn't sound so good. Hey, what was that second part you said again?
Maybe you can give me the names of all your bookies you owe money to, and I could help roll up every gambling ring in the city. I imagine there'd be quite a reward for that.
Hey, I can't do that. Well, I could do that, but I can't do that. Okay, can't you just let me go?
I could, but I'm not.
Oh.
Let me know when
talk. Good day, ladies. I think my work is done here.
I was not expecting that.
I really thought we were going to serve some time, but that would have been so worth it. How can we ever thank you?
There is one thing.
What is it? Anything. Just name it.
How about a lifetime supply of Girl Scout cookies?
You got it.
All right, well, especially those ones with the chocolate and the coconut all swirled in. Yeah. Oh, those are
to
die.
Hey! What about me? Help! Help!
Oh, be quiet. There'll be plenty of cookies for you, too.
Oh, let me go.